Oh, bless you. There's your cold open, Tim. The Calgary Flames chasing down a Western Conference wild card spot. Look who's back. Mike Smith returns after being injured against New York February the 11th. Missed 13 games. Taken on the Isles here. Not a great start. 2 minutes into the first, Nick Leddy scores his 10th. 1-0 Isles. Smith allows two goals in the first three shots that he sees. Johnny Gaudreau. Bruce one short side past Christopher Gibson for his 21st. So that's the good news for Calgary. The bad news is Smith's night continues to get worse. It's friend of SportsCenter with Jay and Dan. And Calgary, sometime Calgary resident, Jordan Eberle with his 24th. Good season, Ebs. 3-1. Third period now 4-1. Matthew Tkachuk, as always, in the middle of a scrum, gets his glove pulled off. And Casey Cizikas just sneaks away with it. And Tkachuk's got to go by and say, can someone just give me my glove? And the trainer's like, New York snaps an 8-game losing streak. Mike Smith on the disappointing return.
I wasn't definitely the start I was looking forward to coming back and playing, but I think it's mentally, it's just you got to put it behind you. You can't do anything about it at that point. So I think it's just you're trying to just keep the team, you know, keep it close. And unfortunately, tonight we couldn't keep it close enough.
It's frustrating. I think the problem is we're getting down a lot at home, and we're pressing a lot. Well, we're forced to press a lot because you're down by a few goals. So that was the case again tonight. You're down, you know, 2-0, and then 3-1, 4-1. You got to press.
Roger loves being in scrum lurkers. He just loves that segment. Hey, it's SportsCenter with Jay and Dan, presented by Tim Hortons. Everyone in Canada on Sunday focused on two things. Corey Connors, Listowel, Ontario zone, with a one-shot lead, going to the final round. And this is amazing. Tiger Woods is back, Dan.
Yeah, when was the last time we had golf as appointment viewing?
Yes. Tiger.
It's been a while.
It's Tiger. It's been a while since we've heard from Stained, too.
Yeah, Stained, hitting Casino-rama this summer. Guys, Tiger would be projected to move all the way up to 76 in the world on one after Tiger hit the par 5 and 2 from 42 feet. Woods for eagle. Yeah. He birdied, moved into a tie for the lead. Corey Connors. This is the 11th final round of the Canadian rookies PGA Tour career. He's a combined 19 over par. On one in the rough from 213,
really needs to get up and
the Listowel, Ontario native hits a low slice into the trees. He bogey, dropping out of the lead on three, facing a difficult putt for par. Connors can't get the 14-footer to fall, and that's about the last you saw of him on your TV. The Canadian with a final round, 6 over 77, finished tied for 16th. Tiger, two shots off the lead on 11. Nearly drops it for a birdie. Still, two shots back, par 5, 14. Woods going for it on two. Into the wind from 252. Tiger, a 2-iron, a club I cannot hit, to the front edge of the green. Dragging his eagle putt 10 feet short. Woods a chance to get within one. Misses. Tiger running out of holes. Needing to finish birdie, birdie to force a playoff. Needing some magic on 17.
Are you serious? There's a little of that old Tiger magic.
I heard a very clear Baba Booey there. Before that 43-footer for birdie, the longest putt Tiger made all day was 9 feet 6 inches. There's nothing like a Tiger roar. It's like nothing else. Woods needing a birdie on 18 to force a playoff. You're hitting the fairway from 185. Uphill into the wind. Tiger hits the green, but it's 38 feet short. Chance for birdie to get into a playoff.
It's gotta go to get there.
Tiger with a final round 1-under-70, one shot behind the winner, Paul Casey. Very rare that a person wins a tournament. We do not show them at all. But the you've got Tiger, it's a different story. Paul Casey, the 109th different winner on the PGA Tour since Tiger's last victory. In a non-major PGA Tour event such as this, Tiger had won each of the previous 23 times where he was within one shot of the lead after 54 holes. But Tiger, yeah, I'd say he's back. Tiger clinches his first top five finish at a PGA Tour event since August 2013. That was 1,659 days ago. In that span, Jay and I moved to another country, eloped, and came back. Mm-hmm. It's been a while.
It's been a while. You got stained on.
I keep saying it's been a while.
You love
I'm
that.
I'm finished
band.
Saying that.
Back to hockey. Sunday, wild card leaders Dallas kicked off a road trip that featured 6 games in 10 days. This is a pretty long and crucial road trip away from home, said Tyler Seguin in the most obvious statement about the Stars since someone asked why Andy Moog's jersey hasn't been retired yet. The problem for Dallas is they ran into Geno Malkin, 36 points in his last 19 games, and hitting John Klingberg and setting up Patrick Hornquist for his 20th. Scoring the empty netter for his 39th. Yes, Geno Malkin, just one back of Alex Ovechkin and Patrick Laine for the league lead. More importantly, the good news for the Flames is that despite their loss on Sunday, Dallas loses as well, and Calgary's still very much in this wild card race, just 2 points back of the Colorado Avalanche.
The Devils and Jackets, they hold down the two wild card spots, but have played 3 more games than Florida, who is in hot pursuit.
And then you got your Canucks and Coyotes. The scoreless in the second, Derek Stepan sees up Oliver Ekman-Larsson for his 10th. And Arizona has the lead. These two teams just want, their fan bases just want to lose. Clayton Keller to Richard Panik. Panik on the streets of London. Vancouver then won. Nice save by Jacob Markstrom there. Brendan Leipzig teed up on the side of the net. Great chance, rings it off the iron. Then less than 2 minutes to play. Bo Horvat to Sam Gagne. Darcy Kemper shuts the door on Gagne. Then in the dying seconds, Daniel Sedin, last shot of the game. Kemper slides across and keeps it out with the blade of his skate. Kick save and a beauty. He made 26 saves. Fourth shutout of the season. Yotes beat Vancouver 1-0.
Toronto Raptors back on the court Sunday in New York, coming off a massive win Friday night in which the Raps ended the Houston Rockets' 17-game win streak. Guess who was there for that one? This guy. I was taking this video when the ball ended up in my lap. Ball, lap.
Why didn't they show the front of you?
Because it's hideous. It's interesting, I got to touch the ball. What'd you do Friday night?
Touch the ball.
Raptors Knicks, Toronto's won 14 of 15. New York's lost 14 of 15. Dying seconds of the first quarter, wraps up 2. Miles with the off-balance 3 at the buzzer, wraps up 5. Second quarter, Kyle Lowry at the free throw line. He and Tim Hardaway Jr. having a little chat. Still beacon. And the ref hands out double technicals. Serge Ibaka gets into it with Hardaway. Had to be separated. Ibaka given a technical. DeMar DeRozan. Knicks in swing possession. Frank Ntilikina drives. Ibaka with the rejection. Two-time NBA blocks leader, averaging just 1.5 blocks this season. Raps take an 8-point lead to the half. They take an 8-point lead to the half. Third quarter, Hardaway in transition. Jonas Valanciunas with a hard foul. Lowry and Hardaway exchanging a few more words. No technicals handed out this time around. Lowry. Coast to coast. It's by the Knicks defense before laying it in, plus the foul. He finished with 16.7 assists. Raps led by 16 after 3. Fourth quarter. Nigel Hayes seen his first action as a Raptor. Knocks down one of his 2 threes. Hayes came from the Knicks G League affiliate and signed a 10-day contract on Tuesday with Toronto. Poking fun at the Knicks bench.
Okay. Gosh, he's beautiful.
Don't do that. Raps cruise to their 8th straight win. They'll seek a 9th straight win Tuesday night in Brooklyn. Sprite Raptors basketball again. Here's how you do it. You fill a glass, lots of ice, dump that Sprite in, and enjoy basketball on TSN 1 and 4.
And that's How to Drink a Beverage with Dan O'Toole. Took him 13 tries to get his first Brier. Maybe that's why it's been such a smooth road to the final for Brad Gushue as he goes for a repeat. I can't emphasize enough how much different this feels from last year and how free we are playing, said the skip from St. John's. It is the Tim Hortons Brier final. Gushue could become the first skip to win back-to-back Brier since 2009 when Kevin Martin did it for Alberta. There's Brennan Botcher. He is also from Alberta, and he is in the way of Gushue and a back-to-back Brier win. Fifth end, Team Canada up 2-1. Gushue facing three. Sits shot stone. Set up a deuce 4-1 Team Canada ninth end. Alberta trailing 5-2. The Botch scores the deuce. Alberta's down one now. 10th end, Botcher's first without hammer. The draw. Right behind the guard. Beautiful stuff. Gushue facing one. Needs a chunk of the button for the wing. Family's making their way down. Here's Vic.
Need the button, fellas.
Off it.
Get off, boys. Need the button, fellas. Molding's right there, and it is two for Gushue.
What a call. What a call by Vic Router. The Gushue rink. Back-to-back wins, and they're off to the Worlds in Las Vegas.
It means a lot to go on a list with the guys that have won back-to-back, Ernie Richardson, Kevin Martin, those guys. What a great team I have here. A lot of fun this week. Regina did a great job. We played real good and very proud of our team. I was just hoping to have a draw and an open draw. Unfortunately, I got it. And, you know, that makes up for last year where I only got 8 points. So, I wanted to have that. And with Brett and Jeff sweeping, I felt real good that they were going
to
put it through.
Chance to defend now your world title. That has to be special.
Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be real exciting. We get to go to Vegas. So that's going to be awesome. I'm looking forward to that. But we're going to celebrate this over the next couple of days. And this was a lot of hard work, hard fought. And, we'll enjoy it.
Still to come, we're not done discussing Tiger. We discuss what his performance means for golf. Coming up, SportsCenter with Jay and Dan, presented by Tim Horton.
LeBron James, an LA Laker? It is 100% still in play. James, a free agent this summer, checking out his potential future office on Sunday night. So every glance, every smirk, every interaction LeBron has with Lakers players dissected and analyzed as everyone looks for a tell from LeBron. He had a triple-double against LA back in December, channeling a Laker great in this one. Second quarter, James looks off Kyle Korver. A trio of Lakers take the bait, and LeBron just flicks it inside for the dunk. He's just three assists shy of a triple-double. Down two in the third.
That was cool.
James pushing. Jeff Green, though, blows the dunk. Did you see that pass? It went through Lonzo Ball's legs. So good. Magic, he needs a better look at that. Isaiah Thomas getting reacquainted with his former team. I don't think they got along that well. Spent just 15 games with the Cavs. Gets his way into the lane. Gets James to back off. Part of a 22-3 Lakers run. Thomas had 20 points. A couple trips later, Thomas finds Julius Randle en route to the hoop. One of his 9 assists. In the fourth, Thomas gets a piece of LeBron's pass, leaks out, finds Randle filling the lane for another hoop stuffer. Randle had a career-high 36 points. He added 14 boards and 7 assists as the Lakers beat the Cavs.
Derrick Rose playing for his fourth team in 3 years. This time it's the Timberwolves. Continue to move. Seeing his first action since February the 7th, they were taking on Golden State. Rose awkwardly stumbles, not hurt, later gets the rebound, lays it in. He had 2 points, and you just saw them. Kevin Durant, 31 points, averaging 31 points over his last 9 from distance. Beautiful shot. He had 19 at the half. Fourth quarter, Warriors actually down 4. Durant finishes. And he stopped on a dime. And then another 3. He had a game-high 39. With Minnie's lead down to one, Carl Anthony Towns. What a shot from the baseline. He had a team-high 31. The Wolves with the upset. I got that information wrong.
And our new clock sponsor, the Bracket Racket Cafe.
Seems like a good place to watch March Madness. You got your packs there sticking out of your...
Oh, sorry. A lot of people wondering, by the way, if you watched Thursday show, what I did with that suit.
And?
It's still in my trunk.
Oh, it's in the trunk of your car.
Yeah.
That's weird.
And now for the stories you need to know, it's time for the Jay and Dan Newsreel. Phillies and starting pitcher Jake Arrieta agreed to a 3-year contract pending a physical. Deal reportedly worth $75 million. Arrieta, the biggest name left available on the free agent market, won the 2015 NL Cy Young Award. You're going 22-6 with a 1.77 ERA last year. A bit of a slow start for Arrieta. Still posted a 2.26 ERA over the last 3 months of the season. And I know specifically why he signed here.
Why is that?
Our good friend Gabe Kapler.
Who would want to play for that guy? Motivational guy. That's. You and I were both shocked that it took this long. All these free agents, it's taken forever to sign them. But
it's been a weird offseason.
I thought he was going to sign way sooner than this. I feel like the David Price deal, the Zach Greinke deal, maybe teams are getting scared off, but he's a great pitcher. He had a great second half. Toronto Blue Jays released outfielder Ezekiel Carrera. The 30-year-old is the odd man out in the Jays outfield after the offseason acquisitions of Curtis Granderson and Randall Grichuk. Carrera hit .282, 8 homers, 20 RBIs for the Jays last season. You pointed this out. He's played more for the Jays than I think we realized.
Played over 300 games.
There's just too many outfielders, and a few of them coming up, too. So just no room for this guy. He'll find a spot for us. He's only 30 years old.
No room at the inn.
That's right.
The New York Giants announced Sunday that they've released cornerback Dominic Rodgers-Cromartie. He was entering the final year of a 5-year, $35 million contract. Rodgers-Cromartie has 30 career interceptions, but had none last season.
Our good friend and frequent guest Mike Garofolo reported that the Giants wanted Rodgers-Cromartie to take a pay cut. How about that ref getting knocked down on the sideline? To take a pay cut, he didn't want to do it. He said, I'll try my hand at free agency.
It's always a tough sell. Want to make less money? Yeah.
How do you feel about that?
Oh, you don't want to do that?
And still play for us? At a high level, give it your all,
that's been the
make less money.
That's been the Jay and Dan newsreel. Oh.
Tiger Woods had an impressive showing at the Valspar Championship this weekend. I don't think I mentioned that was the name of the tournament off the top
of
the show.
Yeah, it's paint. They do pretty good with the paint.
Wonderful paints for your interior and exterior of your home. Finished second, his first runner-up finish in an official PGA Tour event since the 2013 Barclays. Unable to birdie on 18, had a long birdie try on 18, didn't go. Couldn't get that playoff with Paul Casey, who won the event. Still looking for his first win since the 2013 Bridgestone Invitational.
Jeff O'Neill said he's got to go to the Mark Messier.
I saw Jeff send that tweet.
Got to shave her off.
Seems like Jeff just loves just watching sports all weekend and tweeting.
Tiger picks up just over $500,000. Too bad for Corey Connors in that one.
Yeah, tough tough Sunday for him.
Did you see at one point, Tiger was in front of Corey Connors. They showed the crowds with Corey Connors. There was like three people watching.
Nobody there. And he had to play behind him yesterday. Yes. He said it was, you just have to tune it out. But yeah, good for him. Tiger Woods, though, it is truly incredible, speaking of Twitter, how Twitter changes when Tiger plays. Suddenly, everyone's watching golf again. I love it. Lost in the hype of Tiger's round was Corey Connors, who's leading heading Sunday. Many Canadians were very upset when they tuned in as he was unable to hold on to the lead. And you know who's also upset?
Who's that?
The announcers.
Oh.
We now return to our continuing coverage of the 2018 Valspar Championship, and here he is, Canadian. From Canada, Corey Connors, in the lead after 3 days, and he's missed it. That takes him out of the running. I'm sorry, buds. Just that I'm from Canada, and I really wanted the Canadian to win. We go to Tiger Woods on 17, and who cares? I don't even care about this tournament anymore. Where's Mike Weir? There is no Mike Weir. I'm being told there is no Mike Weir. All right, we'll just stare off into the scenics, I guess. I really wanted that Canadian to win. This sucks.
taking it pretty hard.
Yeah, really took it hard.
Nice scenics, though. Video surfaced of Odell Beckham Jr. in a room with what appears to be illegal substances. Short clip shared on Snapchat by a model shows Beckham Jr. with what looks to be a brown cigarette, lying on a bed along with pizza and a powdery white substance. The NFL and the Giants are aware of the video, but have no further comment. And that...
I'm going to get violently ill just trying to keep up with the cuts here.
That wasn't room service pizza either.
Who among us hasn't ordered a pizza, brought it back to our hotel room, and just crushed it?
With an Instagram model.
With an Instagram model. What is an Instagram model? You're an Instagram model. You're on Instagram. You post pictures of yourself. You're an Instagram model.
I'm not making money, though. I think that's their only job.
Really? You could do that?
Yes.
Why are we doing this?
I think
we should be Instagram models. When we return.
You have to show just pictures of your butt and stuff.
Of your butt? You just did that on TV. We saw your mics. We'll be back with Instagram model Dan O'Toole after this. Milos Raonic, the future of Canadian tennis, or is the future of Canadian tennis Felix Auger-Aliassime, the YouTube sensation who's already dispatched one Canadian in Indian Wells, Vasek Pospisil. I read that way too quickly and stumbled over many words. Auger-Aliassime, the world number 169. Raonic was ranked outside the top 1,000 at the same age. Raonic took the first set 6-4, serving for the match in the second. Felix says, not so fast. Sensing his first break of the set, the two trading bombs from the baseline. Raonic should go between the legs, leaving an easy put away. Despite a great effort, Raonic facing triple break point. The teenager going for it on this forehand, but missing it wide. Raonic will win four straight points with a chance to close it out. Huge serve, takes it in straight sets, had great things to say about the kid afterward. But the kid is out at Indian Wells.
Canadians in open wheel racing, they've always been joined. Gilles Villeneuve, Greg Moore, Jacques Villeneuve, Paul Tracy, James Hinchcliffe, Lance Stroll, and now enter Robert Wickens, the rookie from Guelph, Ontario, grabbing the pole in the IndyCar opener. The third rookie since '93 to win the pole in his IndyCar debut. Wickens said he binge watched YouTube videos to learn what to do. And said, I need to polish up on the rules and figure out how to start an IndyCar race. First of all, I had planned on going with the flow. Now, I'm controlling the race. I usually binge watch kitten videos on YouTube. Wickens and his team put on a clinic.
Binge watch?
Binge watch. Did I say bing?
You said binge watch.
Binge watch. Wickens in third passes Graham Ray Hall on the inside to move into second. Wickens on his final pit. His crew gets him in and out in under 7.5 seconds, three faster than Sebastian Bourdais. That gives him an 8-second lead, set him up for a battle with Alex Rossi. Two laps remaining. After a caution, looking to overtake Wickens. Rossi instead takes him out of the race, allowing Bourdais to pass them both. Wickens' fiance's reaction.
He wasn't this close to showing.
Yeah. And she almost drops the... Oh, she held back.
Ooh.
Devastating finish for the Canadian, who finished 20th. Bourdais takes the checkered flag. On fire.
I didn't mention Milos Raonic's new coach, Goran Ivanisevic. Pretty cool. When we come back, esports. The NHL is dipping its toes into the esports world. Fans of NHL 18 will get a chance to compete for a share of the $100,000 prize pool. Qualifying kicks off March the 24th. The finals go June the 19th in Vegas. Now, a lot of people want to win the $100K prize money, including myself. As a matter of fact, I was just practicing before the show and streaming it live on Twitch.
For hockey. Henrik Sedin.
Hey guys, it's your boy Jay here, just streaming on my Twitch. Today I'm playing NHL 18. Get ready for the big tournament. Gonna win myself $100,000.
Jay, it's showtime. Let's go.
Leave me alone. I'm streaming on my Twitch. This is my time. Sorry, guys. Dan thinks he can tell me what to do. Anyway, back to the game.
So, seriously, let's go.
I'm busy. Call Shinetti. I don't care. Anyway, as you can see, I am totally crushing it.
We're live in a minute. If you're not out here, we are through.
Good. I'm glad. I never liked doing the show with you.
I'll never work with you again.
Good. I'll have more time to
Twitch on my Twitch!
Well, I'm actually pretty upset about that. Dan is a hell of a broadcaster and a good friend. Things are going to be pretty awkward between myself, Dan, and Shooter Shinetti now.
Pitching it to Daniel Sedin. Like I say, I was a noob.
Yeah, that guy, he was right. You're a noob.
The Atlanta Hawks, they have an in-game promotion where a fan has 24 seconds to try and stop street ball legend Hot Sauce from scoring. ESPN reporter Darren Rovell got his shot Sunday. It was interesting.
Take it, Darren. Get it. Get. Whoa. Hey. Darren, that's it. Hawks fans, give it up for Darren Rovell.
Darren Rovell is younger than us, yet moves like a man in his 100s.
Darren Rovell was born in 1978. I thought he was born in the 40s. I mean, that's really, you should not be reporting on any sports ever.
Yeah.
If that's how he moves on the court. Anyway, that was funny. I enjoyed that. Hey, it's a major time for gambling. March Madness brackets were revealed on Sunday. We showed it to you. Unfortunately, Dan and I are already down. We bet prematurely on a team that did not make the tournament. That's right, Lakehead University, snubbed again. We're out 75 grand.
Yeah, that's why we're trying to make a little scratch on the side. We're getting into the app game. It's time for the Jay and Dan App Store. These are apps that don't exist, but they should.
Don't wait in line anymore with the Patrick Laine Save the Laine app. You can keep your place in any line and continue on with your business. How does it work? It's easy. Get in a line. Tell everyone you have the Save the Line A app. Hope they know what it is. Run your errands. Return to the line. Convince the new people that's how the app works. Save the Line A. It has almost nothing to do with Patrick Laine.
Now that the New York Giants have released Dominic Rodgers Cromartie, he's more time to play Cromartie Party, the only interactive party game hosted by the actual Dominic Rodgers Cromartie. Compete in mind games, puzzles, quizzes. But remember, if you lose too many games or try to leave the game early, you will get cut from the game and won't be allowed to play again. Cromartie Party, it's actually not that fun.
Finally, if you're in Paris with a French Instagram model and looking to have pizza or whatever delivered to your hotel room, just download the OBJ delivery app. It'll deliver pizza or drinks or anything else you might need. We will literally deliver anything. Wink, wink. Anyway, make sure to shoot us a video and let us know how it worked. That's the Jay and Dan App Store, apps that don't exist, but should.
You know, one app, speaking of food, you know, the diners, drive-ins, and dives?
Mm-hmm.
If you had an app where you're watching the show and you can get the item that they're serving at the restaurant delivered to your door, it'd be amazing.
That is not a bad idea, actually. Call up Guy Fieri.
Our buddy.
Yeah, we met him once. He's a nice guy.
Free tater tots at his restaurant.
Yeah, that was what they served. That was a sad night. When I think about it now.
Nice guy.
Again, if you're a French Instagram model, shouldn't your Instagram videos look better than
no,
that one?
No, people like that.
Okay.
Still to come. The good, the bad, and the downright bizarre. That's right. The Jannies are next. It's the Jannies. Bruins lost to the Hawks on Sunday, partly because of this awful miss by Nick Holden. Well, he had the whole net.
Mm. He had the Holden net. Jeff Teague posted a double-double in the T-Wolves' win over Golden State. The ridiculous circus shot and won. Nice work, Teague.
Patrick Reed needed a two-putt from here to force a playoff at the Valspar. Instead, he left it so short that it rolled right back to him. Yeah, he even waves it back. He finished in a tie for second with Tiger.
And LeBron, this is incredible stuff here. Yes, the Cavs lost to the Lakers. But that was
now.
That was pretty great.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but Friends is the now the new go-to for the younger generation on the streaming.
Yeah, that's streaming on some sort of streaming service. Yeah, that's so not available in Canada.
Yeah, that's what they're doing in America.
Good thing everyone has Crave TV.
He's like, hey, I'm concentrating on this season.
I think Philadelphia. Yeah, we blew it. A bunch of stuff. I really messed up that on camera, that Milos Raonic on camera.
And we got Joey's catchphrase wrong.
It's not, hey, I want some pizza.
And it's binge watching, not bin. Bin watching would be sitting inside a bin.
Inside a bin watching something like Crave TV.
So guess what? We can be better next show.
Yeah. It's the first show of the week, and it's just going to get better from here on out. Hey, by the way, we're only on Monday and Tuesday, and then we're taking the rest of the week off.
What a weekend it was.
Grab some popcorn, put your feet up.
And here we go.
Toronto, best of the East. The Rockets, best of the West.
This guy's at a different level.
My goodness, they've been sensational.
This is vintage.
You ready for a March Madness run?
It's no tomorrow. Somebody is going dancing.
Anything can happen in March.
Look at Davis play and then slam it down.
Sports Center, put it on there.
This is almost unfair right now.
That's just mean. That's cruel.
Tiger Woods is in contention again.
Let's get excited.
There's a little Tiger magic.
He just never ceases to amaze.
There's no doubt. Tiger's back.
And it is two for Guzzo.
They are the best again.